On previous video, you learned what is reservation and how to create one. You learned to create reservations using DHCP console or using PowerShell. You also learned how to find client MAC address and how to test reservation. Join me on this video to learn about DHCP options. IP address and subnet mask are the minimum settings that each computer needs to fully operate in a network environment. Each client on the network needs a few more options and settings to be fully functional. At least, we can mention DNS and default gateway are two of the options that most clients need. In a domain environment, we can add time server and DNS or domain name suffix to the above list as well. Apart from assigning IP address, DHCP allows you to send options to the client as well. You can set options at different levels. Some options are assigned at the server level, and some are assigned at the scope level. And if you want, you can go even further and assign some options at the reservation level. If you need to know how to create a reservation, click on the link on top of your screen to watch the video. The options that are assigned at the server level will automatically apply to all the scopes of the DHCP server as well. With that in mind, it is best to set generic options at the server level and more specific options at the scope or reservation level. Let's look at some example. Imagine your network has several subnets with different IP ranges. Each network will use a router to communicate with other networks and to access internet. This means all the clients of each subnet will use a specific IP address as their default gateway. So, the default gateway IP address is unique to each subnet. If you want to set the default gateway IP by DHCP options, you should set the option at the scope level and set different IP address for each scope. But your domain name is the same for all the clients on the network. All clients will have the same DNS suffix regardless of their network. Therefore, setting the domain name or DNS suffix is best if you apply it to the server level. Any option that you assign to the server options would automatically propagate to all the scopes. This makes your future management tasks easier. If you ever needed to change a value for all the clients on your network, you will only need to change that option at the server level. The list of options are the same, no matter if you select server or scope level. The list is identical. Options are defined by a number and a name. For example, option 003 router is used to set default gateway, or 015 DNS domain name is the name of your domain. Some of the most used options are 003 for router, 004 time server, 005 name servers, 006 DNS servers, 015 DNS domain name, 044 WINS servers, 046 WINS node type, 047 NetBIOS scope ID, and 060 PXE or pre-boot execution client, 066 boot server host name, and 067 boot file name. In order to create and set options, right-click on either server or scope options depending on your needs and select configure options. On the open dialog box, you see the list of all options and their names. To assign any of the options, under the available options section, simply select the option. And then under data entry section, enter the value for that option and click OK. And now your DHCP will start assigning those options as well. In order to assign options using PowerShell, open PowerShell as administrator and start by searching for the commands by typing get-command star DHCP star. On the list, you can find DHCP server v4 and v6 option value. To get the available commands, type get-command star DHCP server v4 option star. As you can see, similar to most other PowerShell commands, you have get, remove, and set commandlets. Also, you can get a list of all available options by typing get-dhcp server v4 option definition. This will list all option ID and their names. As an example, I'm going to add time server option to my server option level. Looking at the list, you can notice the time server option ID is 004. Optionally, type get-help set-dhcp server v4 option value to see the syntax for the set-dhcp command. To set the option at the server level, type set-dhcp server v4 option value dash option ID and enter your desired ID. In this example, time server is 004 dash value and enter the value for your option. In this example, my time server is 192.168.48.200. By hitting enter, you have successfully entered a server option. You can check the result by typing get-dhcp server v4 option value. You can see time server is added to the list. Adding options to scope level is similar to server level. The only difference is that you need to provide a scope ID of the scope that you want to set the option for. In this example, I will set a different time server for one of my scopes. Lastly, if you want to check the option of one particular scope, you can type get-dhcp server v4 option value and then provide the scope ID which you would like to see. Add dash scope ID to your commandlet and type in your scope ID. As you noticed, same command can be used for both server and scope level. In order to see the result for the scope, you only need to add dash scope ID parameters to your command. I hope you enjoyed this video. Join me on the next video to learn about DHCP high availability option. You will learn about DHCP split scope and DHCP failover functionalities. Thank you for watching and see you on the next video.